Hello, everyone. Welcome back to American Truck Simulator. My name is Jeff Aviano, and today we're doing a run from Fresno, California to Kingman, Arizona. So a lot of things have happened, since the new update came out. We're on the Arizona DLC now. I also changed trucks, and we'll get into all of that very shortly. We're going to take this run. Since last time we went to Nogales, we're going to go to Kingman this time. So we'll take that job. We're sitting here in our beautiful Peterbilt 379. You heard me correct. That's not a 389. It's a 379 with a sleeper on it. I'll show you the outside view. Here we are right here. Look at how beautiful this truck is. I absolutely love it. I think you guys are too. Let's pop back up here into the beginning. We need to pick up right there where those cones are is we're going to be picking up. So, a lot has changed. We're on the new version with Arizona. I mean, we had Arizona DLC before, don't get me wrong. But we did not have all the working, modified trucks and stuff working with it. So we had to use the W900 there for a little while. And we were using my multiplayer profile instead. So let's back up here. Is it that one or that one there? Yeah. Oh, it's that one we got to pick up. Okay. I still wish we had a little more room in these yards, but we just don't. So we just have to kind of go with what they give us here. So let's pull over this way and try a little bit better. All right. This will work very nicely. Remember, we have a big truck to deal with. So with that said, I'm using Track IR. I'm still using Paul's squirrels, his thing, but I kind of tweaked it to my own liking because before I thought it didn't have enough, it was too fast, it was too jerky for me. So I turned it down a little bit so it's a little more smoother on the head movement. So we're using advanced coupling. This is why I'm trying to get the kingpin here in a minute. If we can just swing around this way, we might get it in there a little bit more. Is that good? We nailed it. Look at that. First try. There goes the little side thing there. All right, fantastic. We'll pull our parking brake. Let's get out and look at the truck and trailer. Always love doing that. So it's a flat top with a nice wing on the front of it. And we're taking this 53 footer of Walmart. What do we got here? We have tableware, 37,500 pounds going to FedEx down in Kingman is what we are doing. So how about that? It's gonna be a little bit of a long trip, but hey, that's okay. We haven't been in America Truck in a while, right? So I know you won't be upset with that. Let's go ahead and release that parking brake. Wait for that sound to go away. We'll probably have to get some fuel pretty soon. Actually, let's keep those on. Let's go into lower LL. Now, one thing is with this truck, you have to know what you're doing because I'm still using my SKRS shifter. And if you don't know what that is, the link for it's in the description below. You should check it out. If you do decide to get one, if you use my link, it helps me out as well. But I absolutely love the product. I wouldn't drive America Truck without it anymore. So we've gone over that before many times, what I am using with that. Let's go around this way. But yeah, I'm still using that. However, we don't have a digital display in front of us in this truck that tells us, hey, you're in this gear or this gear. You just kind of have to know the truck a little bit. So that's what we're doing. We're clear on the right, or the left, I mean. We're going to the right, clear on the left. Just look over there. I love how with this Track IR, you can pretty much look over that door there. Because with this 379, the biggest problem is the mirrors. The mirrors in this thing are not good if you're not using Track IR. You have to be able to use those and look at them and set them up correctly. So that was the biggest thing, was to do that. But I absolutely love this truck. You'll remember this truck from the days of Euro Truck Simulator 2. I used to use this truck a lot, and it is my favorite truck. So when it came out, naturally, I was like, oh, I have to get this. I have to get this, and it looks so good. So hats off to them. Author of this one, I forget who it is. It's usually a bunch of different people. They use different parts and stuff, but I absolutely do love it, and thank you so much. And it's got a great sounding Jake brake. This is the Creechbaum. I forget how you say his name exactly. His sound set, so you know it's going to be good. All right, let's go into first here. Yep, still looking clear. Let's get going. Looking good. Take this road up this way. I love the sound of this truck. I might have moved that camera that mirror a little too much to the inside, but when backing up, you really want to have that. And we have our little blind spot mirror anyway, so it's not a big deal. We're making a left up here. Start slowing down for it. I will let you hear the Jake brake in this thing. It's that good old sound we used to have in the Freightliner, the classic XL. So very happy to have that back. I love this sound set. It's my favorite. And it's the default engine that comes with this model. And that would be the 308 horsepower. Yeah, we're good there. 308 horsepower cat engine. But it's sufficient. I didn't want anything really ridiculous to get used to truck sim again, because sometimes if you do that, you're changing gears a lot differently with a lot more horsepower. So I wanted something a little bit easier. Since I have this my shifter memorized, I can get through all the gears with, you know, without any issues and all that good stuff. So that's what's going on with that. How are you guys doing? It's Thursday. It is Thursday. I want to say thank you to everyone for, you know, showing a lot of support for Kona. I've been really enjoying that game, and thank you for allowing me to be able to play that and bring it to you guys. I'm very happy that you're enjoying it. I like having a variety of different games on the channel. The reason why I've been kind of light on LSPD4, now don't say that, last week I did a lot more than I normally do, is because we recorded a bunch of Code Zero patrols, and a lot of people like those, but we recorded a bunch of them, and I didn't have very many slots open outside of like doing Kona and stuff for American Truck and LSPDFR. So those two kind of went to the wayside, and we just did a little bit of some different things here. It's just we're gonna go with this gear here. We're in five low. We're gonna take that to get on the highway. Watch our mirrors over there. Looks good. Yep, we're good. Let's get on the highway. Let's do the cheater way. Our favorite way to do it. And that is turn on those hazard lights. It just prevents people from getting in your way when you're getting on the highway. There we go. That worked for us right there. All right. On the road to Kingman, Arizona. So we will get to see some Arizona DLC. And with the track I are on this time, I think we'll be able to see a little bit more of the countryside. And hopefully it'll stay during the day. See, now we're in seven high. That's what that changeover was you were seeing there. And so I can flip that switch back into seven low right now. So when I switch into eight low, I can just go right down into eight low. Not bad at all. That way we're sipping gas. I don't want to go too fast here. We're in a 55. We're still in California. I'm so used to being over there in Nevada that I did not have to deal with that before. So start slowing this sucker down. To go down into fourth, so we'll go into the basement here. Down into third. I think we're in three high, we should be. Yep, three low, I mean. And we are. Okay, I'm keeping it in gear. A lot of you guys want me to keep these things in gear when we come to a stop. So I'm working on that, getting a little bit better at that. All right, we keep it in first gear here, just waiting for our spot to open up. We're gonna go now. So those cars can wait, if that's the case. Just bring the nose up this way on the right. So last night I did my iRacing race. Okay, I was wondering if that guy's gonna give us any room. And it didn't go over so well on the live stream, so I decided to stream America Truck Sim for everybody. But it was a little bit of just shaking the rust off last night, so I'm glad I did, because I got used to driving an American truck and all that again. So I wouldn't be terribly bad whenever I came in and played it today for you guys. But yeah, that's where American Truck's been. LSPDFR, all that stuff. We recorded a lot of stuff with Code Zero, and wanted to get that content out. And we're going to slow down for here because we are coming through Bakersfield and it's so easy to get a ticket here in Bakersfield. So we're going to just keep an eye on this. Let's go. Actually, we're in what, 6 low right now. We'll go to 6 high. There we go. So that way we're not more tempted to do 35 rather than 30 through here. So we're just being careful. Looks like we might get a little bit of an evening drive. Fuel gauge works. See how we're just a little bit below half? If we double check on this thing, you can see we're just a little below half as well. So it's nice having a working fuel gauge. Let's go ahead and go back into 6 low. I'm going to stay in this lane because that lane on the right's going to end not before too long. So anywho, what else is going on? Well, I got Farming Simulator 2015 during the Steam sale, which is pretty awesome. I've been having fun with that. And actually tonight we're gonna do a live stream of Farming Simulator. So that will be fun. And I got it for Nicole, so she can join, which will be a lot of fun as well. Well, we are speeding our butt off here. I'm so used to just getting back up into the 55 mile an hour zone. I'm gonna slow back down for this, let this truck over here. Let him over. He's doing good. So yeah, we got Farming Sim. I think you guys are gonna enjoy that. I haven't decided yet, we might bring that to the channel with the multiplayer stuff with Code Zero, because Zach got it as well during the Steam sale. And during the Steam sale, it wasn't very expensive. Let's turn our auxiliary lights on here. It wasn't very expensive. It was like $13. Couldn't pass it up. Like, well, that's a good one. We got plenty of fuel for right now. We'll get some gas a little later on. We don't need it now. Sorry, diesel, fuel, whatever you want to call it. 40 through here? Nice. I think they increased the speed limit through this area here. Which is, it makes a lot more sense to go from 40 to 65 rather than 30 to 65, you know? Maybe that's why they did it. 55 for us, of course. Let's go around this way. I do love this little road over here outside of Bakersfield. You get to do those little hills. We go down this hill and to the right, and then we get to do the up and downs. Those are a lot of fun. We'll just take our time getting up to speed here. No need to be in a rush. And here comes the hills. Yes, the hills that we know and love. Well, I'll have to get a screenshot during this for sure. Alrighty, I got my little screenshot I wanted. I wanted to get one when I was going up the hill. I think it would look really cool like that. All right, back into the gas, the accelerator, and we are back on our way. But with Farming Simulator, we're going to be doing a live stream of that tonight. So hopefully this will be out before we start that, and you'll know that. But what's funny is that today, well, it's not really funny at all. With that happening, Nicole wanted to jump in and, you know, get used to Farming Sim, and her computer would not start. Well, it wouldn't reboot. It had an instance of, over this course of this week. Let's change into this. Let's go to this one. The downshift. Forgot how much of a hill this is right here. We'll get back into our story in a second here. We go. There's the Bates Motel. Is there anything going on in there tonight? I don't think so. It's not nighttime. You can't see the Easter egg that's there, but it's pretty cool normally. So yeah, earlier this week, she had a USB plugged into the front, you know, those little, those front IO ports there. And, it got ripped out and it broke the USB. So when she went to go restart the computer, it would turn on, it would post, you'd hear the beep, but then it would shut off. So I was like, you gotta be kidding me. I took out the graphics card and tested that first, you know, see if the system would just boot without the graphics card. That was fine. Luckily on her motherboard, it has one of those LEDs to test the RAM. I took the RAM out and reseated it just to make sure. I, you know, checked all the fan hookups and all that stuff and turn our headlights on now. Nighttime. That sun goes down quick. So I did all that. And to no avail, it still had a problem. Get ready for this turn out here. I do like how much easier it is to drive one of these 18 speeds with an actual shifter. That SKRS shifter is just so handy for that. All right, let's make our left turn here. There's nobody coming that way. Looks like we're clear on that side, but waiting on this side here for traffic. Although this bus, is he gonna let us go? Really? Well, thanks, man. I'll take it. Thank you. Watch that side there. Oh, no way. Go ahead, dude. Go ahead. Oh, man. These intersections. Well, it was bound to happen. I was trying to turn it a little bit more just to make that happen. It was just not enough. We went right on the side of that guy's truck. Okay. Get back into the swing of things here and we'll continue our story. I was getting sidetracked. Well, hopefully we didn't damage our freight. We won't get in trouble for that. We'll get gas at the next one. Can I get back over? That truck didn't let me over. Looks like it. Yep. All right, cool. Back on the road. Now, that was a little mishap. It was bound to happen, though. We are still rusty. Oh, there's a police car right there. Nice try, buddy. Nice try. So, anywho, I had remembered that that had happened, so I took off the top part, and then we looked in there, and where the USB was plugged into the little chip there, I just disconnected the USB power to it, those USBs, so, you know, the system wouldn't even know that they're there. And once I did that, it booted right up. All was well. So that was an interesting start to the day. That happened this morning. So if you ever have a USB incident, or you have your computer doing that, and I did try taking the CMOS little watch battery. I took that out and plugged it back in. A lot of people always say to do that. So I did try that as well, and it didn't make a lick of the difference. So it turned out it was the bad USB ports in the front. So all is well now. Her computer is running fine. But if you ever have that issue where you have a broken USB, it's just such a shame that those cheap little ports they put on the front of a case like that can cause your PC to not start. That's a pretty big problem, if you ask me, but what do I know? All right, I mean, getting off the highway up here, the Kingman Flagstaff, east on Highway 40. All right, we can do that. Make sure we're slowed down enough for this turn off. Yeah, and that looks fine. I do love the new roadways in Arizona. They are so good. Man, we do have some bright lights. There's nobody around. Might as well use them, right? You'll be able to see a little bit more, too. Yeah, I know. They flashed me like, hey, man, you're blinding me, bro. Not blinding you. Not yet. Oh, that's not too smart there, Mr. Truck. I guess he was all right, though. So we're technically still in California. We're about to cross into Arizona soon, though. I'll tell you that much right now. I tell you. But hopefully everybody has been doing well. It's been fun to talk with a lot of you guys in the Discord server. If you don't know what that is, I started a Discord server. And also, thank you to everybody for buying those the Fly With Me shirts. Flight Sim content will return next week. Like I said, it's been a hectic schedule of Code Zero videos that's been kind of taking over some of my series. And I want to get back into my flight sim stuff and all that, so that will happen soon enough. We are going a little fast. What are we doing? 5 over. Let's slow down a little bit here, Jeff. Let's go ahead and go to 8 high. We sip on some gas. We do need to stop for some fuel. We're making decent time right now, so we might as well slow down to 55 and set the cruise control. There we go. We got up here. Got a way station in 1 mile. Now, with the new update, I believe that it pops up a lot earlier than it used to. Man, Jazzy Cat did a great job getting all this stuff back to normal. Yep, there it is right there. See? So now we can be prepared for it and slow down. And just Jake break down all the way through the gears. There we go. Down into 3L. Turn those off. And down all the way into first gear here. And what are they gonna say? Bing! 73,436. Thank you for your cooperation. Have a safe journey. All right. We will try to have a safe journey. I mean, we haven't had a safe journey already, but, you know, there's always hope that we can do better. I'm gonna try not doing it the cheater way tonight. I'm gonna try to... Tonight. It's during the day for me, but it's nighttime in the game. I was gonna see if we can get on the highway without having cars in the way. Looks like they worked on the merging a little bit better. Like not spawning cars on top of you when you're trying to merge. Because that always seems to be an issue people run into. Let's see if we have any fuel stations anytime soon. We do. We got a fuel station up there before we get to Arizona. So we're gonna stop there. I think that'll be perfect for us. Up to speed now. Let's go ahead and switch over to... There we go. We'll switch it down into 7 high. And then we have to start the whole process over again. I just remembered always to bring it back down into the low gears, and then I can go down the gears properly the way I want to. There's a truck passing us on the left. Here's the gas stations up here. So we'll slow down here, and then we'll switch back into 7 low. We are a little slow right now. I'm sure they're not happy with us. We're gonna turn our blinker on. We're getting off up here anyway, so it'll work. Not sure how the exit is for this. I think it's... Oh, it's one of these. Okay. There we go. And we'll go back down to the basement. And we're good. Good with that. And let's make room for our trailer. That looks like it's going to be in plenty there. Rev match all the way. There we go. Beautiful. Pull that parking brake. We can kill the engine. And I'm going to turn off Trek IR so I can have a little bit of a rest on my head. We can look outside at the truck. That flat top 379, just such a classic looking truck. I absolutely do love it. Let's fill her up. See what she's got. Turn our auxiliary lights on here. And it's probably gonna be about $500. 471, hey, not bad, not bad at all. I was expecting a little bit more money, but that's okay with that. All right, let's turn our Trek IR back on. We're good. And fire this baby up. Air looks good. Well, that's good. Let's release the parking brake. Wait for the sound to finish. Fantastic. Just get back on the highway and we're good to go. Release that clutch. Turn our headlights back on. We're good there. Keeping an eye out for anybody coming off the highway. Sometimes they get off the highway and they get back on, and you got to deal with that. All right, let's see if we can get merged here. clear on out. Fantastic. Yeah, I think they did work on the just how they spawn in traffic around you. On the road again. Yeehaw. I'm trying to drink more water than soda lately. Been getting some of those bottled waters. You know, that's a whole nother topic there. I remember when we were getting these, was it the Pure Life or whatever it was? No, Ice Mountain. And Ice Mountain is actually Nestle. And Nestle steals those water from those aquifers up in Michigan. So once we learned that, I was like, man, we got to really kind of look and see who we're getting water from. But I think they're all corrupt. I mean, the whole bottle water thing is, it's just a huge mess. It's going to 8 high there. It's just kind of a huge to-do about politics and everything, so I don't talk heavily on this subject, just freely. That truck's behind us. Ooh. Hey, look at that. Welcome to Arizona. Yeah. Good to be back in Arizona. How many miles do we have left? We have 36. Oh, wow. We're getting off up here. We're almost to Kingman. How about that? How about that? Not bad at all. It wasn't as long of a trip as I thought it was going to be. But before I get a bunch of questions about it, yes, I will be doing some more ATS again soon. I missed it. I love it. It's good to have it back. So go ahead and pop that sucker down into that gear instead of what we were driving at, just so we can coast here. I mean, it is a 75 mile an hour zone, but man, this truck is ultra quiet whenever you're not giving it any gas. We're gonna start jake braking now. Really trying to slow this puppy down. There we go. That'll work too. Want to make sure we don't hit somebody, you know? Be really stupid. Coming off the highway like that. Let's put our blinker on. That's a nice looking Charger in front of us. That's an old 70 Charger. It's either a 69 or a 70. I think it's a 69 though. That's the more popular one. And we got a Chevy Impala in front of him. But like I said, Jazzy Cat's been, you know, updating his traffic packs for the newest versions. So it's been pretty cool. All right, let's go into this gear here. Let's watch that mirror. Our trailer's good. We're making a turn up here anyway, so that's all right. I'm just gonna go ahead and go with 4 high here for now. Yeah, let's go up into 5 low. That'll work nice. I think this is it. Yep, that's FedEx right there. Kingman discovered. How about them apples? Fantastic. Oh, hello. Did we not switch back into 4th gear? I guess not. That was my fault. Okay, we're turning in here. Yes, we are. Turn this baby. See where they want us to drop this. And we're using that mod that, you know, doesn't have those little, the big bright green things anymore, so we have to look for our drop-off zone with those little things. I don't know if it's over here or where it is. Let's go into Lolo. Watching a trailer there. Oh, there it is right there. Okay. Bay 3. You got it. Bay 3. That will work for us. We'll just bring the trailer over this way. Yep, right there. That's where they want it. So let's go and turn to the right. And then back to the left. Might put us in a good spot for the trailer. I don't know. We'll find out really quickly here if that will work for us or not. All right, beautiful. No other trucks here, so I'm not really worried about that whole ordeal. Bay 3. We're going to have to probably get this thing turned around a little bit before we can get it all the way into the bay. But I could be wrong. Yeah, we're going to have to get it all the way back around the other way and blindside it in. It's looking like I don't think there's enough room over there with this size of trailer. Let's go ahead and pull up to the right here. Now we can see what we're doing. There we go. I think that's the bay we want. Is that the bay we want? Let's go ahead and pull our parking brake and hop outside and look. Double check. And turn those headlights off. All right. If we were to get out of the vehicle and walk, it'd be so cool to get out and be able to walk back. That would be really neat. Yeah, that's Bay 3 right there that we're lined up on. So a little bit more, it looks like, to the right. All right. So let's go ahead and wait for that sound to go away. We're not lined up on the right bay, so we need to go this way a little bit more. There we go, like that. Be able to see a little bit more here. All right, cool. Let's start the backing in process. Can't really see much in this area particularly, so it's really hard to know what bay we're backing into. That one there is not, it's probably the one next to it, isn't it? Yeah, probably. Yes, it is. Okay. So we had the right idea, we just didn't have the bay. Okay. The next one over. Yeah, you just can't see much with these mirrors in this truck. That's the only downside. Only downside to it. All right, let's try this again. We're just gonna go a little more shallow with it. Let's start turning. Oh, I cannot see anything back there. That is so terrible. I am so tempted to just flip around and do it the other way. Blindsiding is just not fun. I just can't see a thing back there. I see the trailer. And that's the bay, but I'm so worried about hitting that trailer. Let's go pull up to the left here. We might be on the bay already. Just can't see it very well. And if that's the case, then that's fine. If we have it straight, we can use our side here so we can actually see what we're doing. Yeah, that's the bay. All right, let's try it again. Come on, baby. Turn with it. Boy, that 53-footer does not want to turn, does it? No, it doesn't. All right, we're on the right bay, though, so that's good. Now we just need to see it, be able to see the bay. There it is right there. That'll work for us nicely. If my chair doesn't roll away from me, that's always beautiful when that's happening. All right, yeah, this looks good. I hate blinding trailers in, though. Let's walk with it back now. Don't want to hit this guy's trailer over here. And I think we're gonna be all right though. I mean, that's the bay right there. We're pretty much lined up on it. There's that trailer. Looking good. Just keep it going back. We're not too terribly far off. We are. We're so close though, but now we can pull up and we can actually see what we're doing. That's gonna be nice. That is gonna be nice. So let's go to the left. Like this. That's what we're gonna do right here. But now I can see the bay. Put it in reverse. It's all about patience with these 53-footers and having a long base. I don't like the long base trucks very much. That's why I usually go with the short ones. But this doesn't have a chassis for a short one. It's only long, so you only get this. There they go. They're happy with that. We will be too. Let's pull it up. All right, beautiful. Let's pull that parking brake. Woo-wee. Turn off this track IR and have a look at our parking job. Oop. Turned up my mouse sensitivity. Oops. It's not the best, but it'll do. That'll definitely do. We'll decouple it. There it goes. The landing gear comes down as well. And we drove 391 miles. 11 hours, 33 minutes. 68 gallons consumed. That's not terrible. Moving towards that level 21. Ever so slightly. Well, guys, that is going to do it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed. I will see you all very soon for another American Truck. It's good to be back in American Truck. And thank you guys so much for the support on the channel. As of lately, it's been absolutely phenomenal. So once again, thank you guys. I will see you soon. Take care.